Hello everyone, welcome to Himalay IAS classes. This is Keshav Sir's IAS Prelims Lens. We will be covering Modern India chapters on Revolt of 1857, Peasant Revolt and Social Reforms. First question, which one of the following revolts was made famous by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee's novel Anandmat? A. Bhil Uprising, B. Rangpur and Dinpur Rising, C. Vishnupura and Birbhum Rebellion, D. Sanyasi Rebellion. During Bankim Chandra Chatterjee's Anandmat, the Sanyasi Revolt has been discussed. So that is option D. Next question. With reference to Revolt of 1857, who of the following was betrayed by a friend, captured and put to death by the British? A. Nana Sahib, B. Kunwar Singh, C. Khan Bahadur Khan, D. Tansha Top. Here the answer is Tansha Top. Next question. Which one of the following territories was not affected by the revolt of 1857? A. Jhansi, B. Chittor, C. Jagdishpur, D. Lucknow. So here, Chittor is the place that was not affected. Answer is B. It's in Rajasthan region. All others come in the UP and West Bengal region, which were the epicenters of the 1857 revolt. Next question. Which one of the following places did Kunwar Singh, a prominent leader of the revolt of 1857, belong to? A. Bihar, B. Madhya Pradesh, C. Rajasthan, D. Uttar Pradesh. The answer is A. Bihar. Next question. Which of the following pairs are correctly matched? Movement with the person actively associated with. A. Champaran Satyagraha, Rajendra Prasad. 2. Ahmedabad Mill Workers Strike, Morarji Desai. 3. Kheda Satyagraha, Vallabhai Patel. Here we know for sure that the first option is correct and the third option is correct. Champaran Satyagraha, Rajendra Prasad took part in it. And in Kheda Satyagraha, Vallabhai Patel took part in the Satyagraha. Ahmedabad mill workers, we have Anasuya Bai, she was part of it. And Mahatma Gandhiji was there in two main Satyagrahas. The first CDM was in the Champaran Satyagraha. First hunger strike was Ahmedabad mill workers. So answer is option C. Next question. Consider the following events. Indigo Revolt, Santal Rebellion, Deccan Riot, Mutiny of Sepoys. What is the correct chronological order? Here we know that first time Santal Rebellion happened. Then there was revolt of 1857. So, 4 will come next. Then there was Indigo Revolt. And then there was the Deccan Revolt. So, answer will be 2, 4, 1, 3. Next question. Match list 1 with list 2. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. Mopla Revolt, Kerala. B. Pabna Revolt, Bihar. C. Ekha Movement, Bengal. D. Birsa Munda Revolt, Awadh. Here we know Mapla Revolt was mainly in Kerala. Then Pabna Revolt is what was there in Bengal. Then the Birsa Munda Revolt was in the Bihar region. Then we have the Ekha Movement in Awadh. So if you match them accordingly, the option will be 1, 3, 4, 2. Okay. Next question. The Sarabandi or No Tax campaign was led by A. Bhagat Singh, B. Chitranjan Das, C. Rajguru, D. Vallabhai Patel. Answer is D. Vallabhai Patel. Next question. After the Santal uprising subsided, what were the measures taken by the colonial government? First statement. The territories called Santal Paraganas were created. Second statement, it became illegal for Santal to transfer land to a non-Santal. both options are correct, and it's a very important concept. So from then, there was no to prevent the Santal rebellion from again happening. They created this Santal Paraganas and prohibited the Santals from transferring land to a non-Santal. So answer is option C, both 1 and 2. Next question, which among the following events happened the earliest? A, Dayananda Saraswati established Arya Samaj. B, Deen Bandhu Mitra wrote Neel Darpan. Neel Darpan is a play on Indigo Revolt. C, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee wrote Anand Mutt. And just now we have discussed that it talks about Sanyasi Revolt. D, Satyendranath Tagore became the first Indian to succeed in the Indian civil services. And this was in 1842. So the first event that happened among all the four options was Deen Bandhu, who wrote Neel Darpan on Indigo Revolt in 1859. Okay, yes. Let's go to the next question. With reference to educational institutions during the colonial rule in India, consider the following statements. Sanskrit College at Banaras, founder is William Jones. Second statement, Calcutta Madrasa, Warren Hastings. C, Fort William College, Arthur Wellesley. Here we come to know that the correct option is only 2, that Calcutta Madrasa, so option is only B, was established by Warren Hastings. The other options are wrong. There are different founders for them. Next question, consider the following pairs. A, Radhakant Deb, first president of British Indian Association. 2, Ghazalu Lakshmi Narasu Shakti, founder of Madras Mahajana Sabha. 3, Surendranath Banerjee, founder of the Indian Association. Which of the following pairs have been correctly matched? We have to know that the British India Association was in 1851. It was established by Radhakant Deb and Debendranath Tagore. The second option is not correct. 1884, Madras Mahajana Sabha was founded by Subramanya Iyer and Ananda Charlu. A very small hint here is the name Chetty. Okay, that can be one hint saying that he cannot have been the founder of the Madras Mahajana Sabha. Anyway, let's go to the next one, that is the founder of Indian Association. Indian National Association in 1876 was founded by Surendranath Banerjee and Anand Mohan Bose. And all these institutions are the precursors to Indian National Congress. So here the option will be B, 1 and 3 only. Next question, Satya Shodhak Samaj organized the A, movement of upliftment of tribals in Bihar. B, a temple entry movement in Gujarat. C, anti-caste movement in Maharashtra. D, peasant movement in Punjab. Here the answer is anti-caste movement in Maharashtra. Truth Seeker Society by Jyotirao Phule. He himself was a Mali. So he organized these anti-caste movements in Maharashtra. Let's see the CSAT English comprehension passage. A successful democracy depends on widespread interest and participation in politics, in which voting is an essential part. To deliberately refrain from taking such an interest and from voting is a kind of implied anarchy. It is to refuse one's political responsibility while enjoying the benefits of a free political society. Question that relates to this passage is A, duty to vote. B, right to vote. C, freedom to vote. D, right to participate in politics. So if you read the last line, read the passage again. If you refrain from voting, it means that you're refusing your political responsibility and you're kind of implying anarchy from this and just enjoying the benefits of a free political society. So the passage is talking about your duty to vote. Answer is option A. Thank you.